Hello, Atticus authors and self-publishers. Welcome or welcome back to the weekly insight segment here on Atticus's YouTube channel. I hope you have been having a phenomenal week with your writing, and hot on the heels of last week's huge announcement about adding Google Fonts to the Atticus platform, I want to take this time to talk to you about some of the implications and what that means and the new opportunities that may be available for your book aside from just the excitement of using a new font. There are many ways that you can use these fonts for added creativity and even sellability of your book. If you haven't yet watched last week's episode, please go ahead and watch that one. Even though it does have a date stamp on it, the content is still very relevant, and it will help you understand how to use the new fonts library. Now, one thing I want to make very clear is when you're going to use new fonts in your Atticus account, you will notice that it says beta for the library. This is because while our programming team has done everything possible to test all of these fonts for general use and overall reliability, this new library has more than 1,600 fonts in it, so we weren't able to test every single font in every single situation. We've done everything possible to ensure the quality and compatibility of the fonts within the system, but it's always possible there will be unforeseen circumstances and use cases, depending on the variations and fonts that you've chosen, that may act unexpectedly. So just keep that in mind while you're experimenting and make sure you always, always, always proof your content, which is a really great and important rule of thumb no matter what. One of the topics I want to talk about today specifically is using foreign languages, particularly languages that do not use the Latin alphabet. This has been a sticking point for the print versions of books up until this new edition of Google Fonts. Whenever you're creating a PDF file for the print version of your book, the font choices must be fully embedded into the PDF itself, which means that they have to be part of the font family that you've chosen. Until recently, the fonts available in Atticus did not have characters that were outside of the Latin alphabet used to write English and French and Spanish, etc. With the addition of Google Fonts, you can now choose font families that are specifically designed to support languages that use unique characters and other alphabets. I'm going to show you what I mean by that, so let's jump into Atticus right now and take a look. Okay, so here we are inside Atticus. Now, as you can see, I've already changed one of my chapter titles to be in a Chinese language font. This means that I have selected the characters and written it in Chinese. If I open the previewer, you can see that it is showing up in Chinese letters in the default iPad preview, which historically it usually did inside of Atticus. This is because EPUB devices are able to access a digital font library that print books simply don't have the opportunity to use. So historically, when you would transfer over to print, these Chinese letters would get lost. Now, I have already set a specific font inside my book, so you can see it is showing up. However, if I decide to convert this sentence into Chinese, I will first have to write it using Chinese characters. So to do that personally, because I don't read or write Chinese, what I'm going to do is just copy this. I'm going to hop over to Google Translate and use this translator to help me out. When you're writing your books and using other languages, I assume you will have either a professional translator or a grasp of the language yourself, so you won't need to use Google Translate. But if you do, please make sure to have some sort of disclaimer letting your readers know that there may be discrepancies because this is not a professional translation. For the sake of this video, it should do the trick. So I have my Chinese characters copied In order to paste them into Atticus, I need to do this without formatting, so I don't bring in any hidden coding from Google Translate or wherever else you may be bringing in your content from. To paste without formatting on a Mac, you will hit Control-Shift-V. On a Windows computer, that is Command-Shift-V. Or you can always right-click and choose Paste as Plain Text. So now you can see I have the Chinese characters showing up. And if you look at my print preview, if I zoom in a little bit here, these letters are not showing up. That is because even though the font family is enabled for my theme, it is not enabled for the body font. So what I will have to do is actually convert this to a subheading. So instead of using it as a heading like you would on a nonfiction book, I'm going to use this as a heading instead of like a paragraph style. So I'll just select heading 4. And in my theme, I have already set up this as the same font characters. But if I choose heading 3, you will see it just kind of disappears and it does not work. So I have it in my theme. I will show you how to do it, but I've got it set up as heading 4. And you can see it does show up the Chinese characters. Now, as I mentioned, this is a beta feature. Because I don't speak Chinese, I don't know exactly where the line breaks are supposed to be, but I will need to do some manual adjustment because it is running off the page. So what I'm going to do is come to this last section of, actually, I think I need to come to this section here, and I'm going to break this and put it all on its own line. To do that, I'm going to hit Shift Enter, and that adds a line break, but keeps the heading formatting. So you can see it now all fits properly on the page. Depending on your language, if it is one that is read right to left instead of left to right, you can align it this way as well. These are all going to be features that you will have to adjust based on the language and characters that you personally are working with. Again, I do not speak Chinese myself, so I don't know the rules of this language or how the hyphenation works, but that is something that you will need to work out for your book and the language you choose. So now let's see how I got this font into the heading settings. If I click on formatting over here, I select my theme and click the three dots and edit. Now this font is what is called Zikuo Zhao Wei. I may be mispronouncing that. I do apologize. But that is the font that I have set for my chapter heading as well as my subheading 4. And I can increase the size if I want. When you do that, it will also slightly increase the bold factor. And you can adjust until it looks right for your book. Now, you may be wondering how I figured out this is the font that I want to use. Because if I go into my beta library here, Zcool just shows up in English. You cannot tell that that is Chinese lettering. So what I've done to find this font in the first place is actually use the Google Fonts main library. So if you go to fonts.google.com, there's actually a filter where you can filter by language. If I click on this option here, I can choose all the different languages that they have fonts that apply to. So for mine, I used Chinese Simplified, and that is where I found Zcool. But you can also look for Arabic or Greek, Hebrew, Japanese, all the different languages will have different fonts that you can try. Not all of these are in Atticus, but a really great selection are. So once you find it in here, then you can type it into the filter search here, and you will find the different fonts this way, and you can add them to your favorites list. So click on the blue heart to remove or add to your favorites. And once you have it in your favorites library, it will be an option in your choices. One other thing that I want to be sure you understand is we don't necessarily recommend you write an entire book using subheading formatting. So if you're going to write an entire book in Chinese or Japanese, or Greek, or any other language that uses a different alphabet, it may not work great to have it set entirely as a subheading. The fonts will be a little bit bigger. You do have a little bit more padding in between the subheadings and each paragraph. And as you saw, you may have to do more manual adjustments in order to get the lines to break at the correct location, depending on the alphabet and the language you're working with. One other factor is you will probably want to go to print layout and deselect where it says subheadings under your keep options. What the keep option does is it ensures that whatever you have selected here is kept with the next paragraph. So if you have ornamental breaks or subheadings selected and the next paragraph gets bumped to the next page, your subheading or ornamental break is going to go along with it. If you're using subheadings as more of a paragraph style, you do not need that functionality. So you will want to uncheck it here to avoid any extra large blank spaces at the bottom of a page. Once that's done, you'll just want to save your theme. And then you can go through and put as much of your subheadings in there as you want. If you are even using multiple languages or multiple different styles, even if you want to have a different handwriting font, you have from headings 2 through 6 to make these adjustments for yourself with the whole library of Google Fonts at your disposal. If you found this video helpful or intriguing in any way, please do give it a thumbs up. It really does help our channel in the algorithm and encourage more self-publishing authors like yourself to check out these videos. You'll also want to hit the subscribe button and make sure you ring the notifications bell so that you're always notified when I upload new content for you to watch and enjoy. I will see you again soon, and in the meantime, happy writing.